So thank you for waiting for all this time. It was like, I said to somebody, waiting is that compared to today, my basic training in the army seemed like fun, you know, so I'm glad to be here after all this. I will read a story from one of my older collections called Fatso. Surprise? Of course I was surprised. You go out with a girl, first date, second date, a restaurant here, a movie there, always just matinees. You start sleeping together. The sex is dynamite. And pretty soon there's feeling too. And then one day she arrives all weepy, and you hug her and tell her to take it easy, that everything's okay. But she says she can't stand it anymore. She has this secret, not just a secret, something really awful, a curse, something she's been wanting to tell you the whole time, but she didn't have the guts. This thing, it's been weighing down on her like a ton of bricks, and now she's got to tell you, she simply got to. But she knows that as soon as she does, you leave her. And you'd be absolutely right too. And just after that, she starts crying all over again. I won't leave you, you tell her. I won't, I love you. You may look a little upset, but you're not. And even if you are, it's about her crying, not about her secret. You know by now that these secrets that always make the woman fall to pieces are usually something along the lines of doing it with an animal or with a Mormon or with someone who paid her for it. I'm a whore, they always wind up saying. And you hug them and say, no, you're not, or shh, if they don't stop. It's something really terrible, she insists, as if she picked up on how nonchalant you are about it, even though you've tried to hide it. In the pit of your stomach, it may sound terrible, you tell her, but that's mostly because of the acoustics. Soon as you let it out, it won't seem nearly as bad, you see. And she almost believes it. She hesitates a minute and then asks, what if I told you that at night, I turn into a heavy, hairy man with no neck, with a gold ring on his pinky. Would you still love me? And you tell her, of course you would. What else can you say? That you wouldn't? She's simply trying to test you, to see whether you love her unconditionally, and you've always been a winner at tests. And sure enough, as soon as you say it, she melts, and you fuck right there in the living room. And afterwards, you lie there holding each other tight, and she cries because she's so relieved. And you cry too. Go figure it out. And unlike all the other times, she doesn't get up and leave. She stays there and falls asleep. And you lie awake, looking at her beautiful body, at the sunset outside, at the moon appearing as if out of nowhere, at the silvery light flickering over her body, stroking the hair on her back. And within less than 5 minutes, you find yourself lying next to this guy, this short, fat guy. And the guy gets up and smiles at you, and dresses awkwardly. He leaves the room and you follow him spellbound. He's in the den now, his thick fingers fiddling with the remote, zapping to the sports channel, championship soccer. When they miss a pass, he curses the TV. When they score, he gets up and does this little victory dance. After the game, he tells you that his throat is dry and his stomach is growling. He could really use a beer and a nice hunk of meat, well done if possible, and with lots of onion rings. But it's set up for some pork chops too. So you get in the car and take him to this restaurant that he knows about. This new twist has you worried, it really does, but you have no idea what to do about it. Your command and control centers are down. You shift gears at the exit in a daze. He's right there beside you in the passenger seat, tapping that gold ring pinky of his. At the next intersection, he rolls down his window, winks at you, and yells at this girl who's trying to somber ride. Hey baby, wanna play nanny goat and ride in the back? Later the two of you pack the steak and the chops and the onion rings till you're about to explode, and he enjoys every bite and laughs like a baby. And all that time you keep telling yourself it's gotta be a dream. A bizarre dream, yes, but definitely one that you snap out of any minute. On the way back, you ask him where to let him off. And he pretends not to hear you, but he looks despondent. So you wind up taking him back home with you. It's almost 3 a.m. I'm gonna hit the sack, you tell him. And he waves to you and stays in the beanbag, staring at the fashion channel. You wake up the next morning, exhausted and with a slight stomach ache. And there she is in the living room, still dozing, But by the time you've had your shower, she's up. She hugs you guiltily, and you're too embarrassed to say anything. Time goes by, and you're still together. The sex just gets better and better. She's not so young anymore, and neither are you. And suddenly you find yourself talking about the baby. And at night, you and the fatso guy hit the town like you've never done before in your life. He takes you to restaurants and bars you didn't even know existed, and you dance on the tables together and break plates like there's no tomorrow. He's really nice, the fatso guy. A little crass, especially with women, sometimes coming out with things that makes you just want to die. But other than that, he's great fun to be with. When you first met him, you didn't give a damn about soccer. But now you know every team. And whenever one of your favorites wins, you feel like you've made a wish and it come true. Which is a pretty exceptional feeling for someone like you, who hardly knows what he wants most of the time. And so it goes. Every night you fall asleep with him, struggling to stay awake for the Argentinian finals. And in the morning, there she is, the beautiful, forgiving woman that you also love, till it hurts. Thanks.